Together, the Lord is good. God is good all the time. God is good all the time. No, I can't hear you. I say God is good all the time. God is good for me and my family and my pastors. Can somebody say amen? Can somebody say again, amen? I want us to spend more time in prayer today because I feel the Spirit of God has been ministering unto me to pray because the times ahead are very tough moments. Because the moment ahead are going to be very hard moments. But I believe that the power of God shall sustain your life. How many people believe? Just wave your hand wherever you are. I believe that God is with us. The Bible says he shall never leave us alone nor forsake us. Amen. I want to welcome everybody who is watching us through the means of the internet. We thank you for your time. One thing I will ask is just do us a favor, if you will, just share this live streaming, invite a friend, a colleague, a neighbor, a coworker, because we want to pray tonight and we want to spend an amazing moment into God's presence. And I want to thank you all for being here. Can you put your hand for yourself for making it tonight? I know it is very cold, but you were able to come in this house today and join with us. And also, we want to extend our gratitude to Pastor Victor for such an amazing moment that we are spending into God's presence and prayer, for allowing us to be a vessel that God is using tonight. And I also want to welcome you all because God is good. Amen. God is good. Without any further delay, I am going to share for like a few minutes, and then we are going to dive in prayer. If you do have your Bible, just do me a favor. We are in the book of Genesis chapter 22. We're reading from the verse 1 and we are scrolling all the way down to verse 13. You can also read with me if you are watching. We are in the book of Genesis, chapter 22, verse 1 to 13. The Bible says, sometimes later God tested Abraham, and he said to him, Abraham, here am I. He replied. Then God said, take your son, your only son Isaac, whom you love, and go to the region of Moriah. Sacrifice him there as a burnt offering on one of the mountains I will tell you about. Early the next day, Abraham got up and saddled his donkeys. He took with him two of his servants and his son Isaac. When he had cut enough wood for the burnt offering, he set out for the place God has told him about. On the third day, Abraham looked up and saw a place in the distance. He said to his servant, stay here with the donkeys while I and the boy go over there. We will worship, then we shall come back to you. Abraham took the wood for the burnt offering. He placed it on his son Isaac, and he said to himself, and himself carried the fire and the knife. And as the two of them went on together, Isaac spoke up and said to his father Abraham, father. Yes, my son. Abraham replied, the fire and the wood are here. Isaac said, but where is the lamb for the burnt offering? And Abraham answered, God himself will provide the lamb for the burnt offering, my son. And the two of them went on together. In the same way, if you can read with me in the book of Isaiah, verse 53, the book of Isaiah, verse 53, the Bible says that He was oppressed and afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth. He was led like a lamb to the slaughter, and his sheep before her shrill is silent, so he did not open his mouth. Amen. Amen. I am going to share for a few moments on something important, the blood of the lamb. The blood of the lamb. And afterward, we are going to pray. I think we are being taught for the past few weeks that the work that God has accomplished in the cross. Are we together? Are we together? Amen. Okay, cool. I am going to be very short. I know it's very hard to mix both languages, but we're going to try to be as short as possible and also to pray. But the most important thing I want you to remember here, it is after this moment, and the pastor has been talking about the blood of Jesus, the blood of the Lamb that set you free. We have been set free by a highest price, by the ransom of the blood of the Lamb. And then also we understood that the blood of the Lamb was a down payment. Jesus Christ paid the price for you to be set free. Amen. He paid the price for you to be redeemed. He paid the price for you to be set free. So there is nothing that can condemn you, because the work of the cross set you free. What the first man, Adam, violated the law, he brought curse in the world. But Jesus Christ brought grace, and he released restoration in your life. You are saved by a costly amount of the blood of the Lamb. Jesus Christ set your life free, because the blood of Jesus was not Mary's blood. The blood of Jesus was 100% God's DNA. I am here telling you tonight something, that you possess God's DNA in your body. The blood of Jesus, it is God's DNA for you. The blood of Jesus, it is God's DNA against any condemnation of your life. If you have been set free by the blood of Jesus, then condemnation will never hit your life. Then the Bible says in the book of Romans chapter 8 verse 11, it said there is no condemnation because of Christ. If you are in Christ, then there is no condemnation. If you are in Christ, then the past has gone. The blood of Jesus has washed away your sin. Am I talking to somebody tonight here? Am I talking to somebody here? The blood of Jesus has taken away your sin. You know, when Adam committed sin, when Adam violated the law of God, curse was released upon nation. Curse came upon us because the first man, Adam, became an instrument of a downfall. Adam was an instrument of a downfall. He was orchestrating the sin of the world. But God could not fall silent, because he knew that the time will come when he will restore our life. He will restore us back to our sanity. This is the reason why God sent Jesus for you. He sent Jesus to set you free. I am so proud, because the work of the cross has accomplished things in my life. What my father was not able to do, what my mother was not able to do, but Jesus Christ did it for you. What your family was not able to do, Jesus Christ did it for you, Mama Dahlia. What your father was not able to perform over your life, it is Jesus Christ that did it over your life. Therefore, I am so proud, because he sent his son to set me free from condemnation. He sent Jesus Christ to remove me from all oppression. He sent his Jesus Christ as a down payment to pay my debt of sin. Adam brought a debt of sin. But the Bible says that throughout the entire Old Testament, there was no one who was found able to open the book and to break the seals. In another word, there was no man that was found able to pay the cost of your life. There was no man who was found worthy. The Bible said John opened the book and he was crying because there was no man that was found able to open the book and to break the seal. There was no man that was found worthy to open the book and remove condemnation. There was no man that was found worthy to open the book and remove curse. There was no man that was found worthy to open the book and remove oppression. But there is only one man. He was found worthy. He was the Lamb of God. He was found worthy to open the book and to set you free. You are a highest price of what God has sent his son Jesus to set you free. This is why you should never be on the curse. You should never be under oppression, because there was a highly cost. There was a highly down payment. You see, when you want to buy a car, they will ask you to put down a down payment. In another word, the down payment shows the trust that you are going to be able to pay the debt. And Jesus Christ became our down payment. He came down to redeem our life. He shed his blood to set you free. If you are free, why don't you confess him your life? It is your desire. It is my desire to begin to confess that I am set free, not by the means of the world, not by the government of my country, but I am set free because God sent his only son to set me free. The Bible says that Abraham was sitting at the entrance of his tent, and under the heat of the day, when he lifted high his eyes, he saw three men were coming. But what I like is, when the three men came up to him, when he ran to them, he said, "My Lord, you can only see the price of God when you remove your eyes from your problem. You can only see the price that Jesus did in your life when you remove your eyes from your affliction." No, let me repeat that again. Ibrahim was living in a time when he was barren. His wife could not conceive. That was a tragedy. That was a moment of cry. That was a time of sorrow. But the Bible said that Ibrahim did not fix his eyes to his problem. He removed his eyes from his problem and he looked up to the Lord. Today I am here to tell you something. You can only see the price that God had sent Jesus to pay for you when you remove your eyes from your affliction. By the time you will begin to look up only to him alone, then you will realize that he has accomplished a greater and a manifold work upon the cross. The Bible says in the book of Hebrews chapter 12, the Bible says, "Therefore, let us fix our eyes in Jesus, because he was the author and the perfecter of our faith." Today, I am here to tell you something, my dear brother and my dear sister, you who are watching us today. Let us remove our eyes from the affliction of the world. Let us look only to him alone, because he is the only one who has a final say. You are Ibrahim at this moment. You are suffering in a time such as this, when things are not working for you. When you think like, "Well, God, I have prayed for enough. I have sought of your name. I have cried out unto you." Today, I am telling you, by the day you remove your eyes to your affliction, then you will see the Lord. And the word "Lord" simply means a mighty honor. And Hebrews 12:2 said, "Let us fix our eyes to Jesus, who is the author and the perfecter of our faith." Then he said, "For the joy set before Jesus, he endured the cross." What joy was that? Because he was seeing thousands of lives being restored back. I am declaring today that the joy of God, that the joy of the Lord is to see your life being restored. The joy of God was to see us being restored because He paid the price for me. I am no longer a slave, but I am He who has conquered because we have conquered grave with Him. Am I talking to somebody tonight? Are we still together here? Are we still together here? Let us put our heads together. Put your head together. He has restored us because He has conquered grave. And one thing I like is when they reached Sodom and Gomorrah, Abraham was living in a moment where it was very tough to understand life. He could not understand what was happening unto him. And they made him a promise. They say, in next year, in a time such as this, we shall return back to you, and your wife Sarai shall have a child. That was a word. It was a promise that God was confirming that I shall come back to you, Abraham, because you have learned how to remove your eyes from your affliction. You have learned how to remove your eyes from your downfall. You have learned how to remove your eyes from your shame. But we shall return up to you. But when you read the Bible, in the land of Sodom and Gomorrah was a land full of sin. Was a land people have rejected the truth. The land that was undergoing a huge tragedy. They went for destruction. But when they go to Sodom, there were three people visited Abraham. But in the land of Sodom and Gomorrah, only two showed up. But there was one who was missing. What I like about the scripture is that when they went to destroy, it was God the Father and the Holy Spirit that were furious for destruction. But the Son of Grace did not go for destruction. The Son of Grace, He has to accomplish His promise, because He did not come to destroy, but He came to open a chapter of grace. Therefore, the Bible said in the book of Luke that day the scripture was fulfilled, because He said, "The Spirit of the Sovereign Lord is upon me. The Lord has anointed me to proclaim the good news." The Son of Grace was assigned to proclaim the good news to Sodom and Gomorrah. The Son of Grace was assigned to save the city and to set free the prisoner, to set free the oppression, and to release a year of grace, to release a year of grace over your life. I am here telling you something, that the Son of Grace, who was the Son of Promise, who was the only begotten sacrifice that was found worthy upon the cross, He came down to shed His blood so that you can have the repentance and forgiveness of your sin. And God asked Abraham to give Him His only begotten son. But one thing I like, that Abraham has two sons. But what son that God was talking about? He was not talking about Ishmael, but He was talking about the only begotten son, who was the Son of Promise, who was Isaac. Because Isaac is the only begotten son of a faithful man, who was Abraham, a man of faith. Because the Bible says in the book of Colossians chapter 2 verse 17, the Old Testament was just the shadow of the things that yet to come. In another word, God was seeing the sacrifice that He was about to release for the redemption of the world. Because Isaac was not the perfect sacrifice to save the world, but there was one sacrifice, who is the Lamb of God. When the Lamb of God was found worthy to open the book, He was released and He was given authority. And the work of the days of the Abraham and his servant took about 2-3 days. But what I like is when they got to the point of the mountain, it was only Abraham and his son that went upon the mountain, and the servant were left. What I like about the illustration, last time pastor was preaching, he said upon the cross Jesus was surrounded with two thugs or two gangsters around Him. You see, those two people will represent the person that will come across along with Jesus. But in the celebrity of the redemption of sin, it is only God the Father and God the Son that is referred. In the celebrity of releasing your life, it is only God the Father and God the son. This is why prophetically Abraham has to take only his son Isaac and went upon the mountain, because it was only something for the atonement of the redemption of the sacrifice. Today I am here to tell you that the work of the cross was a covenant made between God the Father and his son Jesus Christ to set you free. And the Bible clearly says, when they went upon the mountain, when Isaac looked, he said, we have the wood, we have the fire, we have the knife, but where is the sacrifice? Where is the sacrifice? Isaac asked a question. He said, where is the sacrifice? Because he understood that it was not the perfect sacrifice of your life. I am here to tell you something. There is nobody in your family that will die for your sin. Oh, I don't know if I'm speaking to somebody. There is nobody in your family that will accept to be sacrificed. We have been taught that we have heroes that died for our nation. I do give them a huge shout out, but there is something I want to remind you. There is nobody that can accept to die for the redemption of your life. It is only Jesus Christ who can die for the redemption of life. When he asked, we have the knife, we have the wood, but where is the sacrifice? Isaac was not the perfect sacrifice, but he asked his father, and Abraham looked upon the mountain. He said, the Lord shall provide. The Lord shall provide. And today I am here telling someone something. It is not your family that shall provide. It is not this nation that shall provide. It is not your parents that shall provide. But it is the Lord that shall provide. The church is not looking upon this nation, but we are looking upon the Lord, because it is him alone that shall provide. Abraham looked upon the mountain, facing the mountain upon where Isaac was sent as a sacrifice. And he looked upon the mountain of Golgotha. He said, there the Lord shall provide. In another word, the response of your cry, the response of the atonement of your sin, was a plan set for God to provide something for your life. I am so happy because he has set us free. He has paid a precious ransom to redeem your life. Am I speaking to a redeemer tonight here? Am I speaking to somebody who has been redeemed today? He said, I will pay a ransom for you in exchange of Egypt. I will pay a ransom for you in exchange of your sin. I will pay a ransom for you in exchange of your family bound, of your family tie. He said, I will pay the ransom to set you free today. This is why Colossians 2:14 said that, having canceled the written code. Hallelujah. He said, having canceled the written code, there was a hand that was written upon your life that you shall never make it, that you shall never prosper. But he said, upon the cross, Jesus Christ went upon the cross. He began to cancel a written code that was written upon the life of Tabitha. He said, Tabitha, there is a written code, but upon the cross, I am here to finish the written code. I am here upon the cross to finish your written code. If I am here upon the cross to finish the written code that was condemning you, and that same very moment, your life was not a subject of condemnation. Your life was never a subject of an oppression, because he went upon the cross to remove that written code. And today I am declaring that every written code that was condemning your life to the same downfall, he has set you free by nailing it away upon the cross. Jesus Christ has to become a perfect sacrifice to redeem your life. He has to become a perfect example for our redemption. He has to become a perfect example to save our life. He has to become a perfect example to release a year of favor.
to release a time of favor. This is why in our nation, even this country, we need to pray God so that God can prevent us from any plan of the enemy. That God shall release a year of favor. I know there are thousands of people who are disappointed about the elections. I know there are so many people who are disappointed about the rulers, about the kings of the world. But I am here saying and speaking to you that the work of the cross was foolish to the wise. The work of the cross was foolish to the wise. You can think as a wise man because you see the reality, but I am thinking in the realm of the spirit because I know the work that he has accomplished upon the cross had set me free. I am not an operation, I am not an oppressed, but I am a son of God because of his glory. The work of the cross has accomplished so many things. Because he who brought law in the day that he was engraving the law on the tablet, 3,000 Hebrews were killed. But he who brought grace in the day of Pentecost, 3,000 people were saved. Let me repeat that again. The reason why I like the work of the cross, because the person that brought the law, Moses, the day he went upon the mountain and he was coming down, he realized that Aaron and the children of Israel began to worship other gods. He became furious and he began to speak to the children of Israel for disobeying to the word. That very day he removed the Levite and 3,000 people were destroyed because of the anger of God. But he who brought grace upon the cross, he releases blood as the Lamb of God, as a perfect sacrifice. At the day of Pentecost, 3,000 people were added. He who brought the law, God told him that you are not worthy to remove, you must remove your sandal because you are stepping in a holy place. But he who brought grace, the Bible said John the Baptist spoke about him. He said he is coming, but in him he is, I am not worthy to tie his sandal. If you are stepping in God's presence, because we have found the favor to come because of his grace. He who brought the law, he took us to the Mount Sinai. But he who brought grace, he took us to the Mount of Zion. The assemblies of the firstborn of God. The Bible said in the book of Hebrews chapter 12. We went to the mountain of the firstborn, the assemblies of God. And we celebrated God. We celebrate his mercy. We celebrate his goodness. We celebrate he who is in our life. And tonight I am here to dare you. I am here to challenge you. That because of the work of the cross, you are set free. Because of the work of the cross, you are redeemed. Because of the work of the cross, he shed his precious blood. He shed his precious blood to remove you from sin, to remove you from the condemnation. When he shed this blood, it goes up to the generation to come. I want to welcome all of us now. Like I say, I'm going to be very shortly today, but I feel like we need to pray for the next minute. I want you to realize the work of the cross. From where you are, just begin to realize that how precious he has set you free from the work of the cross. If you can stand on your feet, let us begin to just realizing how much better that God has sent his only begotten son as the Lamb of God. The Lamb that was slain upon the cross. He went there for your name. He went there for your reason. You were the reason why God sent his son to be destroyed, to be killed, in another word, to be nailed upon the cross, so that today you can become who you are. If I am dressed up the way I am, because there was someone who paid the price. If I can walk the way I am walking right now, because there is somebody that paid the price. If I am speaking or of his word, because there was somebody that paid the price. If I am seeing God's favor in my life, it is because somebody has paid the price. I should never worry about what the affliction of the world, about what the world says, but I am so grateful because of his blood. Why don't you open your voice and begin to thank him and begin to praise him and begin to pray because of his blood. Because of his blood, he has set me free. Because of his blood, he has redeemed me. Father, thank you, Lord. Father, thank you, Lord. Lord, we celebrate you. Lord, we thank you, Lord Jesus. What my people say, they say, Lord, we celebrate your name. Lord, we praise you, Lord. Lord, we thank you, Lord. Lord, we thank you, Lord. Lord, we thank you, Lord. Holy Spirit, Lord, we thank you for the living sacrifice of the blood of the Lamb. The blood of the Lamb that has set me free. The blood of the Lamb has set me free. The blood of the Lamb has set me free. Father, you pay the ransom. Lord, 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 you pay the ransom to set me free. Holy, it is again. I am no longer a slave. I am no longer a slave. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. I am not a temple of disease. I am not a temple of suffering. I am not a temple of any condemnation of the punishment of the world. I am not a temple of any wrongdoing. I am not a temple of any bad orchestrating spiritual things that comes to for destruction. I am not set 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 for destruction. Because you sent your son to set me free. 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 You send your son. Rashi Probegege. Mare Sekret. I want to remind you something. Ibrahim, Isaac, Nehemiah, Daniel, all these people in the Old Testament, they were not redeemed by the blood. But you and I, we have been redeemed by the blood. The blood of Jesus came for your ransom. It came to pay a down payment to set you free. Yes, Lord. You are not a slave because somebody accepted to be crucified so that you can be set free. He accepted to be humiliated upon the cross so that you can become a living creature. He accepted the humiliation so that you can have a life. Father, we thank you today. Lord, we thank you because you accepted the humiliation. Lord, we thank you today because you accepted the humiliation. Holy Spirit, Lord, we thank you.
Merci, Jesus.
Lord,
merci,
we thank
Seigneur.
You.
Father, we bless
yes.
you. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
Can we all stand, please, in the presence
yes.
of God? Est-ce qu'on peut tous ensemble
s'élever? Yes.
Avant yes. qu'on termine, je veux que tu pries. Selon la parole que nous venons de suivre.
Yes.
L'homme de Dieu nous a fait voir l'importance du sang de Jésus. He showed us the importance of the blood of Jesus. Le sang de Jésus a annulé la malédiction. J'aimerais te donner une minute. Tu vas prier pour annuler toutes les malédictions. Les malédictions de ta famille, les malédictions de tes origines, toutes les malédictions qui régnaient sur toi.
Yes.
Tu vas dire, Seigneur, au nom de Jésus,
yes.
par la puissance du sang de l'agneau, j'annule.
Yes.
Peut-être que tu es né d'une famille maudite, d'une famille où les choses n'avancent pas à cause du sang qui est en toi. L'homme de Dieu nous a dit qu'en toi tu as l'ADN de Dieu. Alors tu vas dire, Seigneur, ton ADN n'a pas de maladie en lui.
Yes.
Ton ADN n'a pas de malédiction en lui. Je
yes.
brise toutes les malédictions. Est-ce que tu peux prier au
yes.
nom de Jésus?
Rocher, clé de guerre.
Bien aimé, ta façon de prier maintenant. Lift up your voice. Say in the name of Jesus. I'm not cursed. Je ne suis pas maudit. Moi, je suis béni. Je suis en train d'annuler toutes les malédictions autour de moi. Toutes les malédictions de mes origines, même de mes ancêtres. Peut-être que tu ne connais pas bien ta famille. Il y a des gens qui ont fait des offrandes, qui ont fait des sacrifices pour livrer toute votre génération. J'aimerais que tu t'élèves ce soir sur l'autel du sacrifice de Jésus pour dire à partir de ce soir, j'annule la continuité de cette malédiction. J'annule cela au nom de Jésus. Je déclare par la puissance du sang de l'agneau, ma vie est libre, ma maison est libre, mes enfants sont libres. J'annule toutes les malédictions. Que le sang de l'agneau commence à effacer. Que le sang de Jésus commence à annuler toutes les lois qui subsistaient contre toi, toutes les ordonnances qui subsistaient contre ta santé, contre ton mariage, contre ton travail. In the name of Jesus, be released now. I proclaim the grace and the favor of Lord in the name of Jesus. Bien-aimé, proclame la victoire, proclame la victoire. Déclare au nom de Jésus, moi je ne suis pas maudit. Ma vie est bénie, ma famille est bénie, mon travail est béni. Je refuse le blocage, j'annule toutes les paroles qui ont été prononcées le jour de ma naissance. J'annule toutes les paroles qui ont été déclarées avant ma naissance. J'annule toutes les paroles qui ont été déclarées pendant ma naissance. Toutes les paroles qui s'élèvent contre moi, je les annule par la puissance du nom de Jésus, par la puissance du nom de Jésus. Merci Seigneur.
Yes.
Merci l'agneau de Dieu. Seigneur, nous te disons merci pour le sang de l'agneau.
Yes.
Nous te disons merci pour l'œuvre de la croix.
Yes.
Merci parce que tu nous as aimés.
Papa,
tu as donné ta vie, Seigneur, comme les down payment. Tu as payé nos dettes, tu as payé nos problèmes afin que nous vivions la paix, la joie, la restauration. Seigneur, je déclare dans la vie de ton peuple ce soir la délivrance totale.
Yes.
La restauration totale.
Yes.
Père, que tout ce qui était bloqué dans leur vie soit débloqué ce soir au nom de Jésus. Ton sang n'a pas de date d'expiration. Les médicaments que nous prenons, Seigneur, ont des effets pendant une période. Lorsqu'ils atteignent la date d'expiration, ils n'ont pas d'effet. Mais nous te bénissons parce que ton sang n'a pas de date limite. Depuis que tu l'as versé, il est encore efficace jusqu'à ce soir. Je déclare au nom de Jésus que le sang de l'agneau couvre la famille de quelqu'un. Que le sang de Jésus couvre la maison de quelqu'un. Que le sang de Jésus localise ton problème et reçoit la délivrance, reçoit la guérison dans le nom de Jésus de Nazareth. Merci Seigneur. Merci pour ce que tu viens de faire ce soir. Merci pour ton serviteur et merci pour la parole. Merci pour nos bien-aimés qui ont, Seigneur, sacrifié leur temps pour venir écouter ta parole et pour passer ces moments avec toi. Même ceux qui nous ont suivis en ligne, Seigneur, laisse que la même grâce soit leur partage. Que ton Église comprenne qu'il y a un prix que tu as payé pour que nous vivions gratuitement par la grâce et par la faveur de Dieu. C'est dans le nom de Jésus que nous avons prié avec foi et conviction. Toute l'Église nous disons Amen. Est-ce que tu peux acclamer le Seigneur? Oh, comment tu acclames comme ça? Est-ce que tu peux acclamer correctement le roi de gloire? Amen. Nous allons nous asseoir juste pour une minute. Are you happy tonight? Tabitha, ça va? Tu as suivi la parole? Amen. God bless you so much. Que Dieu bénisse le pasteur Elijah. I know that it was in English. We are in America. You have to learn English as well, right? Can you put our hands together for the glory of God? Thank you so much. So, God bless you so much for your time. We will meet again on Sunday. Nous allons nous retrouver encore dimanche à 17h. Je veux vous remettre quelques invitations ici. Même nos bien-aimés qui nous regardent en ligne, invite quelqu'un dimanche. Ce sera un culte spécial le 31 janvier. Ce sera le dernier dimanche du mois de janvier et en même temps le dernier jour du mois de janvier. Donc, ne manquez pas de clôturer l'année avec le Seigneur. Nous l'avons dédié. Déjà un mois va finir bientôt. Donc, les choses vont tellement vite que si tu es distrait, tu vas encore terminer 2021 toujours la même personne. Donc, il y a des choses que Dieu ne fera pas à ta place. C'est à toi de prendre la décision et de savoir comment te comporter pour vivre le changement dont tu as besoin. Donc, je vous invite, please, dimanche, à partir de 17h30, nous commençons notre culte et à 20h juste, nous allons terminer. Que le bonheur et la grâce de Dieu, lève ta main droite, je vais prier pour toi. Seigneur, merci pour ce soir. We bless your name, God, for your word. Thank you for everything you have done among us tonight. Thank you, God, for blessing us with your word. Thank you for the blood that you shed, God, for our freedom. I believe that tonight, each and every one, God, we are free. There is nothing that can stand against us because your blood have been shed for us. I worship you, God, and I bless each and every one. May the grace and the peace of God be with us. In the name of Jesus, someone can say amen. Que Dieu te bénisse. Nous allons nous retrouver dimanche à 17h. Merci beaucoup.